Hello everyone, my name is Sally Wahba. I'm a software engineer at Splunk, and today I'm going to share my perspective as a developer as I'm thinking about SLOs from on-prem to cloud. So a little bit of background about myself. I've always been a software engineer in a developer capacity, so I was never QA, SRE, or DevOps, for example. And for close to a decade, I worked for a data storage company where our main product was an operating system for data storage, and it mostly ran on-prem. And currently at Splunk, I work for Splunk Observability Cloud, which is a SaaS offering. So I'm going to talk a little bit about on-prem versus SaaS for development, production, support, and operation portions of the product lifecycle. So in terms of development, when I worked on-prem, our release cadence was roughly 6 months. So every 6 months, we would have a major release for the operating system, and we would have patch releases roughly every 4 to 6 weeks. And as a developer, I really relied on that because I had a lot of soak time for my code if there are any issues that can be found. And with on-prem, we controlled so much of the hardware and the operating system, and so we had 6 nines of availability. And we had so many layers of QA, which is really a luxury. We did have a lot of constraints from the dev side where we couldn't really write a lot of unit tests, but a lot of layers of QA helped solve that. And in terms of measuring things from a developer's perspective, so we measured things, for example, like the time between the QA found bugs and the number of tickets an engineer has, or the number of customer cases that an engineer needed to be involved in, or the number of high severity bugs, whether these bugs were found by QA or by a customer. And we also had an entire organization dedicated to performance. So whether that is creating new features to make the performance of the system better, or having an entire team dedicated to running industry standard benchmarks to compare and check how our system is running. And if there are issues or if there is code that gets checked in that can cause a performance degradation, that code was automatically backed out. In terms of SaaS, we are a microservice architecture. And so it really depends on the team that owns the microservice on how often they want to release to production. And so we roughly average once a week of pushing to production. And we are running on the cloud, and so we have restrictions on our SLAs, and we have restrictions on the availability because it depends on the availability promised by the cloud provider for the services that we run. And so we have 3 nines of availability. And we don't have as many layers of QA, so developers have an added responsibility of ensuring the quality of their product or the product and the code that we write. And so we rely a lot more on unit tests, which is a nice thing to have that I didn't have the luxury to do when I worked on-prem. And we measure things such as code coverage, for example, from the unit tests. And we rely a lot more on code reviews and the feedback that we get from code reviews. Again, we don't really have the luxury of soak time that we did in on-prem. So in terms of production, so again, the main product was an operating system. The way we released it was we made it available on the customer support website, and then customers would download that operating system and install it on their production environment. And so as a developer, I didn't have to deploy anything to production, and I didn't have access to production because there was no production environment to have access to. So how do I know how the software is behaving in the field? So we have this software that's called Auto Support that would periodically send telemetry data back to the customer support organization. But then there were issues with this because a customer has the right to disable the auto support. Even though we don't get any customer identifying information back, the customer can still disable auto support. especially if they're running in an air-gapped environment, for example. So we as developers don't have a whole lot of information and knowledge about how the code is running in the field. And even the telemetry that comes back, it comes back to the support organization, and it's much harder for the dev to have access to that information. And so knowing how the code is running in the field took a lot longer for us as devs to know. Versus in SaaS, well, we as developers deploy to production, which is good and bad, because then we can cause a misconfiguration and cause an outage. That's something we didn't have to worry about on-prem, for example. But we also have access to production, and we have a lot of information and telemetry available to us to know how the software is running. And we can create all kinds of charts and dashboards to know how the software is running. And in terms of support and operation, when I worked on-prem, we had a dedicated support organization, and I was never really on call. Yes, I was involved in helping solve support cases and answering support questions, but I was never on call. No one woke me up at 2 o'clock in the morning to ask me a question or ask me to help with an escalation or an outage. But then an issue with that is we have delays and bug fixes. So as I mentioned, a patch release is released roughly 4 to 6 weeks. So even if I can get a bug fix checked in quickly, it still won't reach the customer until the next release or the next patch release. And even when the customer has access to it, they themselves have to update their operating system, which they themselves can take a lot longer to do. And so a bug fix can take weeks or even months for the customer to benefit from. So in SaaS, it's quite different. So yes, we have a dedicated support organization, but we also go on call. So because we monitor our own services, we have our own alerts and dashboards and detectors, we can react much, much faster to how our product is, whenever our product is misbehaving. And bug fixes are much, much faster to reach the customer. Well, because we're running on the cloud, there is always a gotcha, right? So if the cloud provider has a breach in their SLAs, well, we could also have a breach in our SLAs as well. And that happened one time when I was on call and the cloud provider had a breach in their SLAs for one of the caching services that we ran and relied on. And that in turn caused us to have a breach in our SLA. Yes, I know that this could happen in theory. Yes, I knew that we are bound by the SLAs of the cloud provider, but it was a whole different thing to see that in real life. And it was really an eye-opening experience because now I think a lot harder about the software that I'm writing because I'm thinking more about my colleagues and myself. I don't want any of us to wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning to answer an on-call detector firing. And so in conclusion, working on on-prem and SaaS has been quite different for me. I had to shift my perspective about how I think about SLOs. Each one had its own constraints that I had to work with and deal with. So it's been a lot of fun both ways, and each comes with its own challenges and rewards as well. Thank you for listening, and I hope that was a good use of your time.